My name is Trinity Roman Preston, and welcome to May Day 2020. These are not ordinary days, and because of that, this ceremony will not be our ordinary way of celebrating the tradition of May Day here at Mercy. Necessarily, we are using virtual means of honoring the patroness of our school, Our Lady of Mercy. However, even though we gather differently, our devotion and desire to honor Our Lady remains as strong as ever. So, we welcome you to this ritual and invite all of you to join us in prayer. As we begin, we would like the members of the May Court to introduce themselves. We will begin with the juniors.
Good morning. My name is Claire Adams. I am a member of this year's May Court.
Good morning. My name is Lucia Lanahan, and I am a member of this year's May Court.
Good morning. My name is Riley Reformat, and I am a member of this year's May Court.
Good morning. My name is Christine Seeger, and I am a member of this year's May Court.
And now, I invite all the senior members of the May Court to introduce themselves.
My name is Juliana Falcone, and I am one of the senior honor attendants.
My name is Paige Spieler, and I am also one of the senior honor attendants.
My name is Judith Lanahan, and I am the crown bearer.
My name is Trinity Roman Preston, and I am the proclamator.
My name is Laura Junior, and I am the maiden.
As a community of faith, let us pray together the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Let us open the ears of our hearts to hear God's word.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Thereupon Mary set out, proceeding in haste into a hill country to a town of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leapt in her womb. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and cried out in a loud voice, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. But who am I that the mother of my Lord should come to me? The moment your greeting sounded in my ears, the baby leapt in my womb for joy. Blessed is she who trusted that the Lord's words to her would be fulfilled." Then Mary said, "My being proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit finds joy in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his servant in her lowliness. All ages to come shall call me blessed. God has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He has shown might with his arm. He has confused the proud in their innermost thoughts. He has deposed the mighty from their thrones and raised the lowly to high places. The hungry he has given every good thing, while the rich he has sent empty away. He has upheld Israel, his servant, ever mindful of his mercy. Even as he promised our fathers, promised Abraham and his descendants forever." Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and then returned home. The Gospel of the Lord. A couple of years ago, I came across the song "Christmas Lullaby," written by Jason Robert Brown, dedicated to describing the inspiration that is Mother Mary. A particular line struck me: "I'll never have the power to control the land, or conquer half the world, or claim the sun." I keep coming back to that line. Mary, the woman remembered throughout history, was not a powerful person by her society's standards. A young girl in Roman-controlled Palestine had little influence, little control of her own life, and little agency. In short, she had nothing that modern American society would consider a hallmark of power. Yet she was perhaps the most powerful human in history as she brought the Son of God into the world. What this song has captured is that Mary had no control over the world. There is wisdom in acknowledging this, I feel, because control is so often coveted. But Mary's story reminds us of the difficult truth that we cannot control the world. During this global period of uncertainty, I think that we all want to fix things. I know that I have been restless with the desire to do something, with the wish that I have the power to restore the old days, our previous normal. I'm sure that many of you have been feeling a similar longing. But Mary teaches us to give up the quest for control and to be at peace with the uncertain. Mary showed us a different model for life's biggest question and life's biggest quest, modus vivendi, or how to live. When I was asked to give this reflection, I immediately reached out to my grandma. Mother Mary is special to my grandma, my Nona, who has a statue of Mary by her bedside and has given many a child a lesson on the beauty of our Heavenly Mother. My grandma was not given an easy life. Growing up poor in southern Italy, she lost her father and two brothers to a natural disaster at a young age. I remember finding a picture of them in her bedroom, strange men who looked shockingly like my father. I don't think that I ever truly understood my grandmother's story and my grandmother's pain until I saw my grandmother's features, my own father's features. Memorialized through ink and a small frame in a country that my great-grandfather never saw. My grandma left Italy with my grandfather, seeking a better future. I don't think that either of them expected to stay in Canada, then America, for the remainder of their lives, leaving home behind and entering into a new culture, an unfamiliar language, the unfamiliar but characteristic American spirit permeating society. Yet despite how easy it might have been to turn bitter at the lack of control she had, the twists and the turmoil of her life, the tremendous sacrifices to give her children a better future, my grandmother is the most religious person I know. She turns to God in times of trial, in times of joy, in times of peace. And she's always loved Mary. When I asked her for advice, she told me that Mary was beautiful, not because of wealth, worldly power, physical appearance. Mary was beautiful because she was humble, because she was loving, and because of her joy. When I read the Magnificat, the power of Mary's joy inspired me. She had just been given the most important, most difficult, most painful task for the rest of her life, to raise the Son of God, to accept utter uncertainty, to place her trust entirely in God, and although she didn't know it at that time, to see her son murdered before her by the corrupted law. In the Bible, we find Mary not swelling with pride at her own importance, or despairing of the difficult task ahead. We find Mary hurrying to help her cousin, bursting with joy in God's goodness. I think that was what my grandma was trying to tell me. Mary is beautiful through her joy. Mary is offering a new answer to that eternal question of life. Live with joy and trust in God. Gloria, glory, I will sing the name of the Lord, and he will make me shine, as Christmas Lullaby so poetically put it. During this time, when we are faced with some of the most difficult challenges ever posed to us, perhaps Mary's lesson is more important than ever. Trust in God. Turn to God. He will not take away difficulties. He certainly didn't erase the tremendous trials that Mary faced, the cross that she had to bear. But he was there, and Mary found joy. There is no greater gift that we can give to others than joy. Joy is just as contagious as any pathogen, and with joy, anything is possible. Mary's life exhibits one more key ingredient, I believe. She lived for others. In Christmas Lullaby, this selflessness is conveyed by the words, "I will give the world my eyes so they can see." Mary didn't give the world her eyes. She gave it something much more precious, her heart. Time and time again, we see Mary helping others in the Bible at the wedding at Cana, on her journey to help Elizabeth. The sacrifice of helping, of serving, is where she drives her joy, I believe. During these tumultuous times, a community can come together well apart. We lack control over the world, but we have control over ourselves. And at this time, we can spread joy and hope through waving to the stranger that you pass on a walk, through calling an old friend or writing a letter, through reaching out, through reminding everyone you know that you care, that we are alone together, not together alone, that we are a community and we can be strong when united despite any differences in location. We can infuse our community with joy. Focusing on joy seems an impossible quest, but even if we can cause one stranger, friend, or family member to smile each day, we are infusing our community with joy. and that itself is a cause for hope. I would like to take a final minute to address my 151 senior sisters in the class of 2020. I have never met more incredible, astounding young women. We forged a community through years and laughs and have grown up together. You were the ones who taught me about the essence of Mary. I've seen it pour out of each one of you through sharing smiles in the halls, through the causes that you stand up for, through the helping hands that you are always willing to offer, through the moments we've shared at senior retreat and during all of our years together. When I was listening to my grandma celebrate the beauty of Mary, my mind immediately went to each member of the class, spreading joy to everyone that you encounter, nourishing the circle of mercy through friendship. For the lesson that you've taught me on the essence of Mary, I will forever be grateful. Although this epoch is less than a fraction of a blink of an eye of the universe, remember that the community that we have created is still strong and that we are together, although apart. Although we will never have control over the world, the circle of mercy that binds us together can and will withstand anything thrown at it. There is still cause for hope and still cause for joy, as Mary has taught us.
Let us join in our general intercessions. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. Mary, your son Jesus served all with respect and compassion. May the church and all her ministers serve God's people with the same spirit Jesus did. And may government leaders also serve with respect and compassion. Lord, hear our prayer.
Mary, your son Jesus said, peace I give to you, my peace is my gift to you. May the world embrace the ways of peace. May all people learn to live in harmony. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Mary, your son Jesus had a special heart for the poor and the oppressed. May all of us continue to be inspired by his example and by the legacy of Catherine Macaulay as we seek to serve those in need. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Mary, your son Jesus called us to love one another. May we love our families, our friends, members of the Mercy community, and our brothers and sisters around the world without reserve. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Mary, your son Jesus healed those who were sick of mind, body, and spirit. We pray for those whose economic status, occupation, or environment make them vulnerable to illness. We pray especially for those affected by the coronavirus. May we respond with great care to those in need of your healing touch. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Mary, your son Jesus taught that the merciful are blessed. May this school community truly be a school worthy of its name, Mercy. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, hear our prayers this day as we honor Mary, Our Lady of Mercy.
Like her, help us to trust your call to be bearers of Christ to the world.
We ask this in Jesus' holy name.
Amen.
Blessed is she who believed, for God has done great things for her. Mary, Mother of Mercy, be with us as we pray.
Loving and gracious God, we ask your blessing upon this crown to honor Mary, the Mother of Jesus. These flowers are the work of human hands and remind us of the beauty of all creation. O God, may this symbol remind us of Mary's openness to God's call and of her faithful discipleship. May we always respond to the Spirit of God, acting in our lives as Mary did. We pray and ask this blessing in the name of Jesus, her Son, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
God of mercy and compassion, fill us with the same spirit of openness and love that filled the heart of Mary. Through her intercession, may we be people of mercy and justice. Mary placed her trust in you, and all creation rejoiced in the birth of her Savior, Jesus Christ. Bless us, O God, with faith, joy, and the vision of the gospel. Amen. Thank you.